In our last session, we were thinking about Israel's golden era when David was the best king that the country had ever known. And into that sense of having the best king that the country had ever known, a man after God's own heart, God speaks to and through David to say, I am the shepherd, I am the good shepherd, I am God the shepherd, the one who wants to be the best leader and the best provider for the people that you could know. Time moves on, and after David comes a series of kings, and their loyalty to God begins to falter. And there is a civil sort of breakdown within the nation, and the nation of Israel splits into two, the northern kingdom of Israel and the southern kingdom of Judah. And the northern kingdom of Israel, they choose not to follow God, and they follow after idols. They're very unfaithful to God. And in 722 BC, we see that the Assyrians come in and they conquer and they take away the northern kingdom. The southern kingdom is a bit more mixed. They have good kings and bad kings, kings who follow after God's heart and kings who don't. And ultimately, this leads to a point in the year 605 BC where the Babylonians begin over a 20-year period to carry off the Israelites into exile. The second half of the Old Testament is made up of a lot of prophetic books where prophets are calling the nation to faithfulness and speaking into what will happen if people don't follow God and aren't faithful. We see a lot of the heart of God being revealed through these prophets, where God's heart breaks for the unfaithfulness that he sees, that's often represented as being like adultery, where the people run after other gods. And it's into this sort of mix of unfaithfulness, of people having to live with the consequences of that, that God begins to reveal a little bit more of his character to a number of his prophets. Have you ever stopped and wondered why sin is such a bad idea, such a bad thing? I've often come to the conclusion that one of the reasons God hates sin is because of the damage and the hurt and the pain it causes to us as his children. And we see with the prophet Jeremiah, a prophet raised up to challenge the nation as it's breaking apart and being carried off into exile, calling this nation to faithfulness. And in the middle of all of this, we see God revealing a new part of his character that actually points to one of the other central themes of the Bible. God reveals himself as Jehovah Tsidkenu, which is a strange name but literally means the God of righteousness. Righteousness literally means being right, doing the right things, having a right standing. And it's one of the central biblical themes, because without us being made right, we can't stand before a holy God. That's the point of the cross. That's the point of Jesus coming to die, is that we can be made right with God. We can have a relationship. We can stand with God. And as God reveals himself to a nation that's being unfaithful, a nation that's walking away, a people who are choosing not to follow him, he reveals himself as the God of righteousness. This is an important thing to understand, because the first thing it shows us is that God is right. God is righteous. And the Bible clearly presents time and time again that God does what is right, he is what is right, and he thinks and behaves and does at all times what is right. But it also shows us a second thing, and that is we as human beings, having broken that relationship with God in the Garden of Eden, we're not right. We're unable to make ourselves right with God. And we need a way to be made right with God if we're going to have a relationship with him. And that is why Jesus came. The Bible says there's no one righteous, not even one. And yet when we look at Jesus, we see that sense of Jehovah Jireh, the God who provides another way, stepping in and taking our place on the cross, substituting himself that we might be right with God. That's the New Testament, and we see it shadowed here in Jeremiah, where Jeremiah experiences, recognises and speaks to the people of the God of righteousness. He recognises that God is right. We need to be made right with him, and points the people to a way to do that. That means coming back in an old-fashioned word that means repentance, that says actually, you know what, I want to turn my back on going my own way and walk a new way with God. Are you at a place today where you need to turn around, repent and go in a different direction and know the God of righteousness?